Please sit.
Thank you.
his compassion came down to us and became flesh. He chose to taste death to save us and descended in the realm of the dead. By his resurrection, he gave joy to his disciples and gave light to the nations with the light of his salvation. To the good one be glory and honor on this blessed Sunday and all the days of our lives and forever.
Oh, no. some fell on the path and was trampled on, and the birds in the air ate it up. Some fell on the rock, and as it grew up, it withered for lack of moisture. Some fell among thorns, and the thorns grew with it and choked it. Some fell into good soil, and when it grew, it produced 100-fold. As he said this, he called out, "Let anyone with ears to hear listen." Then his disciples asked him what this parable meant. He said, "To you it has been given to know the secrets of the kingdom of God, but to others I speak in parables, so that, looking, they may not perceive, and listening, they may not understand." Now the parable is this: the seed is the word of God. The ones on the path are those who have heard, then the devil comes and takes away the word from their hearts, so that they may not believe and be saved. The ones on the rock are those who, when they hear the word, receive it with joy, but these have no root. They believe only for a while, and in time of testing, fall away. As for what fell among the thorns, these are the ones who hear, but as they grow on the way, they are choked by the cares and riches and pleasures of life, and their fruit does not mature. But as for that in the good soil, these are the ones who, when they hear the word, hold it fast in an honest and good heart, and bear fruit with patient endurance. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God. For in me has his words of life. Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God.
As I was reading the gospel, I all of a sudden remembered when I was in the novitiate, we had some classes with other brothers from other religious communities, and there was also communities of sisters that were there. And this particular gospel had been read, and one of the novices, one of the guys, said, "Isn't it interesting that it's always the women that Jesus had to drive out the evil spirits and infirmities?" And then one of the girls in the novitiate said, "That's because he's still trying to do it with the men." I hope he keeps trying. It's a very, I really like this gospel a lot, because there's just so many thoughts that are invoked within this, that with the word of God, he is, in telling this parable, he's letting us know in some ways that there are certain things that he teaches that just doesn't make any sense at first. That it does sound like a parable. It's got a message, but exactly what does it mean? And the positive side of that is that we should be sitting there wondering and trying to sort through it. And then when we try to figure it out, come up with our ideas of what it might mean and what it might mean to oneself and to others in the group and discussing it, then he goes and reveals what it means and what he meant to him. Because in all things in life, we do have to be able to reflect on. We do need to think about it. And it has to be according to our personality. That comes out in the first reading when some are arguing, "Well, we're followers of Apollo," you know, and the other one says, "No, we're followers of Paul, and Paul's great list goes on. It's like being in the seminary, where, as Franciscans, we thought we certainly had one over on the Dominicans. And the Dominicans certainly thought that they had something over on us. But that is because each group has its own type of personality, its own type of spirituality. If you're highly detailed in your theology and you want everything clearly black and white and very distinct and very clear with hardly any gray areas to consider, then you'd be a Dominican. No, I don't think there's any Dominicans here. But if you're Franciscan, you listen to what Jesus says and realize that he was a very understanding and compassionate person, and we all line up behind him, but it's a crooked line. And all of us are somewhere in there. We have our security levels, our way we were brought up, the culture that we're in. All of us makes a difference in how we understand and believe what he has to say and in what manner. But when we get to towards the end of the gospel, he points out the very core of understanding, the Word of God. That it's important for us to be able to identify and know ourselves well. We need to know our personality. Are we prone to be critical? Are we usually just, for whatever reason, maybe we pick it up from our culture, our parents, we usually find fault before we find value. We have to know what are our rocks. What is the path? What part of us does not listen to the Word of God, and it takes very little to distract us from it or to rationalize it away? Are we very selective? What are the thorns? What are the things that seem to choke us off spiritually? We need to know this. We need to know what our weaknesses are to not let them choke us off. Maybe some of us become extremely workaholics to deal with stress, and we're thinking we're accomplishing a great deal, and maybe we are. But have we begin to neglect God? Or maybe we become immersed in only good works, and we forget all about having faith in Jesus. And so that our good works gradually become only for our ego, and only to impress, and only to feel good about ourselves, and we can never do enough. The challenge in our life is to find the moderation. And that is how Jesus ends the story. To bear fruit with patient endurance. I had a friend in the seminary that had a plaque on his wall. It says, "Lord, grant me patience right now." Well, I can tell you it never happened. We can't rig these virtues. You can't become a patient, loving person by trying to avoid every situation that gets on your nerves or seems to rub us the wrong way. You cannot build up endurance by sitting down and doing nothing. You can't get in the Olympics and run a race or be the fastest swimmer if you only sit in a chair and look at the water. You can give all the advice you want, you can give all the opinions you want, you can even sound intelligent giving all that advice. But can you swim? And are you willing to do what it takes to endure and to be patient? You aren't, and I certainly include myself. I can imagine myself being the most patient person in the whole world and can endure everything as long as nobody comes around me. then it's nothing. That isn't anything. It's living in a fantasy world. To grow spiritually, to produce the right type of fruit, we have to develop the character. And it's not easy. It comes with trials and tribulations. It can come with turmoil and heartbreak. But we learn to be a genuine, patient, enduring person. When we seek with empathy and understanding and compassion, and look at the whole situation and know that within all of the storm and all of the chaos, you know that God can still touch the hearts of His children. To not argue about Apollo or Paul, or Franciscans or Dominicans or Jesuits, each are very important in capturing the personality of the people that they serve. But the intention is for knowing Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the giver of life, redeemer of the world, the Prince of Peace, that one that visits us and walks with us and is with us.
Thank you.
life and your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon us often all those who please God with hand to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom the sacrifice is offered, for Richard. Remember also all those who can share with us today in this offering. If I have a debt I need,
give me my was who touch, how I would have done that, give me my feet, what can I be, or what in the room is that shall I not, not a good time, how I think it has seen.
Lord.
Let us give thanks, O Lord, sacred words which in the language in which Jesus said, the seed lift off of a good ground for 100-fold. Mi amor, adakama shadile, ma bebe haye,
yeah.
especially Francis, the Pope of Rome, Bishop Peter, Patriarch of Antioch, Gregory John, our Bishop, and all the bishops, pious priests, pure deacons, and all who serve the holy altar, we pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy. Remember, O Lord, all those who call upon your holy name. Bless those who are near and bring back those who are far. Visit the sick, strengthen the weak, release captives, and assist the oppressed. Bring back those who strayed that they may live in your fear, and reward those who have brought offerings to your holy church. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, our civil leaders and all the children of your holy church. Grant them security and peace, and keep domestic and foreign conflicts far from them, so they may live in tranquility. Protect them by the sign of your living and victorious cross. Rescue the persecuted and displaced of your flock, and be a refuge for strangers and a companion to travelers. Grant your eternal reward to monks and those who live solitary lives, and to hermits who live on mountaintops and in caves of the earth. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, upon this altar and upon your heavenly altar, the holy, ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the prophets, apostles, martyrs, confessors, evangelists, John the Baptist, the forerunner, Stephen, the archdeacon, and first martyr, St. Joseph, St. Jude, St. Mary, and all the saints. May we join in their ranks and share in their joyful feast. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and a consecrated life.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, the faithful teachers who have gone to their rest in the true faith, especially Peter, Paul, Mark, Clement, Ignatius, Dionysius, Julius, and all those who have endured suffering and persecution for the strengthening of your holy church. Remember also those who serve your holy altar. Forgive their sins, that they may reach your joyful dwellings. We pray to you, O Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We pray for all those whose lives are, and they feel like they're being choked out by all the cares of the world. They'll find peace and find it in the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all those who have left this world and have gone to you, especially Richard. Lead them to your joyful dwellings and blot out all their sins. For our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, who is without sin, we hope to find mercy and forgiveness for our sins and for theirs.
Grant rest, O God, to the departed, and forgive the sins we have committed, with or without full knowledge.
Grant us pardon, God, and forgive us in the departed, so that your blessed name may be glorified in us and in all things, with the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that of your living Holy Spirit, now and forever.
As it was, it is now, and shall be forever.
Of God the Father, you are merciful and compassionate. You have sanctified this divine service and have perfected it in your good pleasure. By the grace of your only Son and by the descent of your Holy Spirit, sanctify us now, that we may be renewed as your spiritual children, so that with pure hearts and enlightened souls, we may call upon you, O glorious Father, and love from all people, praying.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Deliver us, O Lord, from every temptation of soul and body, and crush our enemy, the evil one. Grant us your mercy through Christ Jesus, our Lord, who are blessed and glorified with him, and with your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of it, and receive the blessing from the Lord.
O Lord, look upon us, your inheritance who bow before you, and guide our steps on your right path. Make us worthy to share in the sacrifice, and make and sanctify the souls and bodies of those who receive it. Through Christ Jesus our Lord, we glorify and honor you in your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and consubstantial, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit, blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord God, so that our bodies may be sanctified by your holy blood, and our souls purified by your forgiving blood. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for the blood. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Body and blood of our Lord.
delicious. And also there will be no Tuesday 9 o'clock a.m. liturgy the day after Monday. Well, anyways. Oh God, the Father, how can we who are unworthy thank you for your grace, for you have given us this divine gift, and have made us worthy to share in the body and blood of your only begotten Son, who saved us. We glorify and honor you in your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, you are worshipped and you are holy. Bless and forgive the priests who are the stewards of your people and of your holy church. Forgive the servers of your divine mysteries and all the faithful who have shared in this sacrifice. Care for the orphans, help the widows, assist the poor and the distressed, satisfy the hungry, and protect all who call upon your holy name in every place. May your name be glorified as that of your Father and of your Holy Spirit, who is good, life-giving, and consubstantial with you, now and forever. God peace, my baby.